Hello and namaste to everyone. Today in this video, we are going to learn a very interesting concept known as trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. So today I am going to tell you how sine 90 minus A is equals to cos A cos 90 minus A is equals to sine A tan 90 minus A is equals to cot A and cot 90 minus A is equals to tan A. Sec 90 minus A is going to equal to cosec A and cosec 90 minus A is going to be equal to sec A. So this is what I am going to share regarding the trigonometric ratios of various complementary angles. And we are going to prove and see how interestingly sine 90 minus A is equal to nothing but cos A and the other values. So let's start. Let us take a triangle A, B and C, right angled at angle B. Let angle A be equal to theta. Okay, let angle A be equal to theta and let angle C be equal to suppose beta. Okay, so now let us try to find out the various values. Sine theta is equal to what? Sine theta is equal to side opposite to angle theta, that is BC upon hypotenuse, and hypotenuse in this case is AC. Sine theta is equal to what? BC upon AC. Cos theta is equal to what? Side adjacent to angle theta upon hypotenuse. Side adjacent to angle theta is AB upon AC. Tan theta is side opposite to angle theta, that is BC upon side adjacent to angle theta, that is AB. Right? If I have calculated sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, can I calculate cot theta? Cot theta is just the reciprocal of tan theta. That is 1 upon tan theta, that is 1 upon BC upon AB, that is AB upon BC. Right? Now, sec theta is equal to 1 upon cos theta, that is 1 upon AB upon AC, that is equal to AC upon AB. Cosec theta is equal to 1 upon sine theta, that is 1 upon BC over AC, that is equal to AC over what? BC. Can I say this? So in this, so like this, we have find out the value of sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta. Now let's try to repeat the same exercise but with angle beta, that is with angle C. Is going to be equal to what? Side opposite to angle C or side opposite to this angle beta upon hypotenuse. Which side is opposite to angle beta? AB. So can I say AB upon hypotenuse is equal to AC? cos theta will be equal to side adjacent to angle beta. Which side is adjacent to angle beta? BC. So can I say this will be BC upon what will be upon hypotenuse? So AC. Tan of beta will be equal to, tan of beta is side opposite to angle beta, that is AB, upon side adjacent to angle beta, that is BC. This becomes BC. Now, what will be cot of beta? 1 upon tan beta, that is 1 upon AB upon BC, that is equal to BC over AB. Sec beta will be equal to 1 upon cos beta, that will be equal to 1 upon BC upon AC, that is going to be equal to AC upon BC. Cosec beta is going to be equal to 1 upon sin beta, that is 1 upon AB upon AC, that is equal to AC upon AB, right? That is equal to what? AC upon AB. Now let's make a table. Sin theta was equal to BC upon AC. Cos theta was equal to AB upon AC. Tan theta is equal to BC upon AB. Cot theta is equal to AB upon BC. And sec theta is equal to AC upon AB. And cosec theta is equal to AC over BC. Sin beta is equal to AB upon AC. Cos theta is equal to BC upon AC. Tan beta is equal to what? Tan beta is equal to AB over BC. Cot beta is equal to BC upon AB. Okay. Cosec beta. Sorry, first sec beta will come. Sec beta will be equal to AC upon BC. And cosec beta will be equal to AC upon AB. This is what we have learned till now. Now, just see, sin theta is equal to what? BC upon AC. And cos theta is also equal to what? BC upon AC. So, can I say sin theta is equal to what? Cos theta. Because sin theta is also equal to BC upon AC. And cos theta is also equal to BC upon AC. So, I can say sin theta is equal to cos beta. In this similar manner, I can say cos theta is equal to AB upon AC and sin theta is equal to AB upon AC. So can I say that sin theta is equal to cos beta and cos theta is equal to sin beta? In similar way, if you will see, tan theta is equal to BC upon AB and cot beta is equal to BC upon AB. So tan theta is equal to cot beta and tan beta is AB upon BC while cot theta is AB upon BC. So tan beta is also equal to cot theta. Sec theta is AC upon AB and cosec theta is AC upon AB. So I can say sec theta will be equal to cosec beta, right? And sec beta is AC upon BC while cosec theta is AC upon BC. So I can say sec beta will be equal to cosec theta, right? If I have to write this, so I am removing this table and writing these equations which we have find out. So, see now. Very interesting thing will come here. This is what we have proved. is equal to cos theta. Cos theta is equal to sin theta. Right? Tan theta is equal to cot theta. Cot theta is equal to tan theta. Sec theta is equal to cosec beta. And cosec theta is equal to sec beta, right? Now, what is angle beta equal to? This is a right angle triangle A, B, C. This is 90 degree. This is equal to theta. And this is equal to beta, right? Do I know angle A plus angle B plus angle C will be equal to what? 180 degree. By property of triangle, sum of all the interior angles of a triangle is going to be equal to 180 degree. Now angle B is what? 90 degree. And angle A is theta and angle C is beta. So theta plus 90 plus beta is equal to 180 degree. Right? That is theta plus beta is equal to 180 minus 90. That is theta plus beta is equal to 90 degree. Right? Theta plus beta is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, I can say beta is equal to 90 minus theta. Very important thing. Angle beta is equal to 90 minus angle theta. Right? Now, let's put this value of beta here. Let's put the value of beta, that is 90 minus angle theta, in these above equations. Right? Beta is equal to 90 minus theta. I hope this is clear to you. If it is not clear to you, you can watch the video again. And if you have any doubts, you can always leave it in comment section. Now let's put beta here. All beta is going to be, this will be 90 minus theta sine 90 minus theta cot 90 minus theta tan 90 minus theta cosec 90 minus theta sec 90 minus theta. So have we proved the equations which I have mentioned in the first part of this video, which I have mentioned in the starting of this video, that sin 90 minus theta is equal to cos 90 minus theta, or you can say cos 90 minus theta is going to be equal to sin theta, or cos theta is equal to sin 90 minus theta, or sin 90 minus theta is cos theta, vice versa. So this is how we have proved the and find out the trigonometric ratio of various complementary angles. So, I'm just sharing a one small example with you how these kind of questions come in exam, and more examples I will be discussing in upcoming videos. If you have question, find out the value of sine 15 upon cos 75 degree. Now you may wonder, I don't know the value of sine 15 degree or cos 75 degree. I know the value of only 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree or 60 degree and 90 degree, because these are the most common values which you remember. But you don't know the value of sine 15 or cos 75 degree. So how are you going to solve it? Simple, by using the concept which I have shared with you before. Can I say cos 75 degree? Can this be written as cos 90 minus 15 degree? 90 minus 15 is what? 75. So can I write this 75 degree as 90 minus 15 degree? Right? And what is cos 90 minus theta? Using this cos 90 minus theta is equal to sine theta. Using the same analogy, cos 90 minus 15 is going to be equal to what? Sine 15. Right? So I just have to put this here. So this will become something like sine 15 upon sine 15, which will get cancelled and we get the value as one here. So this is how we have solved this question. I hope this video is clear to you. If you have any doubts, please mention it in comment section. Do subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you. Enjoy learning.